Good evening. Thank you for joining us on our show, Dog is Family. We're so happy to have you with us tonight for our holiday show. We have so much to talk about, so we have a very quick agenda, and I'd like to introduce some guests briefly. We'll be telling a story over here with Amy and her daughter, Kira, and their golden doodle, Gabe. So welcome, and thanks for coming, Amy.
Thank you, Barb. We're
glad
to be here.
We're so excited. And, of course, we have Denise, Lacey again, our trainer in-house, who helps us with all kinds of problems and issues and fun stuff. So we're going to be talking about that. We'll look at some really new and different hot products for the holiday. And then we'll end with a special guest. So thanks again for joining us tonight. I'm the host, Barb Emmett, and let's get it started. When I looked at December, I said to myself, what did people do with traditions in their household with their dog? And many people are incorporating their traditions with their dog doing things with them. So we ask for input from people, and here's what we got. If we can show sharing holiday traditions. The first thing we've heard is picking out the Christmas tree, and I can tell you that's a big tradition in my family. We like to take our goldens out and look for a tree, and locally, we've heard that Plow Farms in Robeson Township allows you to bring your dogs out on leash, which is really fun, and do some looking for that perfect tree. My husband and I took our boys up to a place called Ruff's, and that was a lot of fun in Orwigsburg, where we hiked the hills. We roasted marshmallows in one of their pits up there. We found the tree, and we had a blast. So call your favorite place that you like to take an adventure to and see if your dogs are allowed and take them out for an adventure. Some other holiday tips we heard that people do with traditions are sprucing themselves up, going to the salon for you and your hair, and your dog going to the groomer. Groomers are very busy this time of year. Let's see if these are the kind of things that you're enjoying with your dog. Stockings hung with others. My dogs have their own stockings by the fireplace, so usually they're filled with toys, and we like to wrap them, and they like to unwrap them, and that's a lot of fun for us. Planned quiet time at home together. We all love to be home with our dogs and snuggle in, but thinking about it ahead of time is really sometimes very important. One of our viewers had told us her story, and this is Linda. She said, every Christmas Eve I make a bowl of popcorn, turn out the lights except the tree, and Parker and I watch the movie A Christmas Story. We curl in the couch with our blankets, share popcorn, and enjoy the movie. I have done this with him since I adopted him 5 years ago. I love snuggling with my boy and enjoying the Christmas spirit. I love Parker with all my heart and soul. So see, she's built quiet time in her busy, busy schedule. Making holiday treats is another one at home. Many of us make our cookies. Well, think about making homemade treats. We have a lot of recipes we can give you. Another person told me that they like to take a Christmas Day morning walk together, and it's a lot of fun. Some others are Santa Claus and Santa Paws photos every year to see how we've all changed. Events in dog-friendly places. Holiday attire, you like to think of what you're going to wear for the holidays, and many people like to think about what their dogs are going to wear, whether it's as simple as a new collar, a bandana, or a pretty sweater. So that's part of tradition. Extra special treats or dinner on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. We do hear a lot about that as well, coming in and talking about the kinds of things they'd like to make. So here's Simply Me. I thought I'd throw that in. This is our two goldens hiking at Ruff's. And the other part that I thought was really nice about going to Ruff's as well, they're very friendly folks there. They donate $2 of every Christmas tree sold to their local Hillside ASPCA. So that's just giving back to all those that we care can find their forever home. So that made it extra special. This is Parker the Beagle, who makes an annual visit to see Santa Paws, and he gives him his wish list. And Parker needs to do that every year. He loves doing that. This is another story that we did get from one of our folks, and it was a very precious story, Silent Night, Holy Night, with Mystic and Charlie. Beautiful labs, and she told her story to us. And it's very important that it's a beautiful story that I hope I'll share by the end of the program tonight. So those are some traditions. I'm sure you have your own as well. Think of including them in the rest of your family. And that brings us to a very natural break in our program to now talk to Amy Auchenbach, her daughter Kira, and her puppy Gabe. I was very happy to meet Amy and Gabe at my shop, and when she I started to ask Amy questions. And when I asked her why did she bring Gabe into her life and what was her story about Gabe, she had said to me, you know, I really wasn't thinking about having a dog. She said it wasn't really my idea. She has three children, and it was all of this has evolved. So when Amy looks back on her addition of Gabe, this beautiful golden doodle, into the family, I was charmed by her story. So I'm going to ask her to share that with us for Christmas, because it really is appropriate for the Christmas time.
Oh, thanks, Barb. We've enjoyed having Gabe so much. A year ago at Christmas time, my husband came to me, actually the day after Christmas, and he said, I have something that I want to talk to you about. And I thought, oh, what could it be? And he said, I really think it's the right time for us to get a dog. And it's not the first time he ever brought that up to me. I think over the past 13 years as we've been married, he's mentioned many times he's wanted a dog, but it just didn't seem like the time was right. And so I kind of pushed it off and delayed it as much as I could. But this time it was a little bit different. Maybe he just caught me at the right time, right after the holiday. Aww. And our kids are now older, and I think that helped me to feel more comfortable with it too. We have an 11-year-old and a 9-year-old and a 7-year-old, and thought it would just be a great experience for our kids to have someone to care for and to love and to build a relationship with. And I think that's really what we've seen over the last year, is that we've developed a really nice relationship with this little guy who is busy.
He's a very busy little man, and he's only a year old.
Yeah, his birthday is coming up just in a few days. He's a Christmas Eve pup, so he's going to turn one on Christmas Eve, and we're excited to celebrate that first birthday with him.
Tell us about how you named Gabe.
Oh, okay.
Was it a family decision? Was it,
it was
input from all of you? And how did you come up with his beautiful name? Can someone tell us that?
Do you want to tell?
Well, we were all eating like dinner at the table, and my dad, he said, why don't we make up Christmas names for our dog? And we thought of Gabriel the angel.
Oh.
And we, if it were a girl, maybe Hope, because of Christmas, and you could have hope and stuff. But luckily we had a boy, and we named him Gabe.
Yeah, we thought Gabe was a neat name, just because we wanted to keep it something that was close to the meaning of Christmas. And we thought about the angel Gabriel, who came to Mary and Joseph and announced that there would be a baby born. And that messenger brought good news of great joy. And so we thought, oh, this puppy, we really hope that he is a messenger for us and brings us good news and great joy, and he's done that so well for us, and we've just been really thrilled to and surprised by how joyful it's been to have him in our family. So,
oh, that's a wonderful story.
Yeah, thank you.
It's just a beautiful story to share. We see that Gabe is wearing something that will probably be his holiday tradition.
Yep.
He's wearing a bandana.
His Christmas bandana.
And he also then needs to be incorporated in all your traditions of his birthday being on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
How do you plan on
helping
him celebrate?
It's fun to have kids to come up with wonderful birthday dog ideas. So we are just having a little celebration with our family, and we are going to have a pajama party. And we are going to have popcorn and watch
The
Polar Express with Gabe.
Lovely.
And we thought that that was just the right speed for him and for us.
That is lovely. Yeah. And a year ago today, you wouldn't have thought about
we
that.
We wouldn't be planning dog birthday parties a year ago, but yeah.
And again, that's new traditions in the family that you will always remember. Does he have a stocking yet?
He does. He has
Did
a stocking.
Did you pick a stocking, Kira? Yep. Oh, very nice. I bet Gabe's going to have it filled with lots of things. Maybe some things we'll be showing you tonight.
Yep.
That's excellent. And tell us a little bit more about the research your family went through, because one of the things I will say is at Christmas time we try to caution people not to rush out before the holidays to get a dog, because it's not the best of times, because the household is unsettled, it's different, there's company coming, you're busy, people are preoccupied. And certainly if you're starting with a puppy, reputable breeders typically do not want to place a dog in the home.
Right.
before Christmas, even though people get very excited about having a puppy and a new dog for the holidays, it's not always the best thing for them.
Yes.
So you all then, your husband gave this idea to you.
Right, yep.
Then you had to do some research. How
did
you start? Did he think of a golden doodle, or had you come up with the breed?
My husband had been secretly researching for 6 months.
Oh, very good.
And with
very
Kira.
Good. Yeah.
She was also part of the secret. And pretty much narrowed down a lot of dogs that they didn't think would work for us. We have some allergy issues, and Art and Kira looked around quite a bit and researched different dogs and thought that having a golden doodle would be a good choice for us. So in narrowing down that process, they found some local breeders that they thought would be good to work with, and we were so excited to find the one that we did work with, Laura at Crescent Moon Kennel. She was super and continues to be super in referring us to different things that are new to us along the dog journey. But we found her, and Gabe was, I think, 9 days old when we went to see him. So he was tiny. We couldn't hold him, and his eyes weren't even open. But made a commitment to get a puppy from that litter, and at Valentine's Day was when we brought him home.
Oh, so you have another holiday to celebrate then.
Yeah, we have lots of holidays to celebrate.
That's his gotcha day when he came home.
Yeah,
That's fabulous. And a golden doodle, tell us a little bit more. People typically will say, oh, I know it's a golden and a poodle.
Yep.
But of course there's great variations in poodles and who and what sizes for breeding. What else do we know about Gabe?
Gabe's dad is named Copper, and he is a miniature deep red poodle. He's beautiful, just a very unique color, and he weighs about 15 pounds, and his mom is a golden doodle. She's a mix of the golden retriever and a poodle, and she's about 35 pounds. So he is almost full size, we think, and he's about 20 pounds now, and we're anticipating maybe 22 or 23 will be the top of his range. So he is very fluffy.
He's very fluffy. How is he for his grooming, Kira? Do you have to brush and comb him?
Well, when we brush him, we kind of have to like hold his mouth because he hates it when we brush him. Yeah. So then after that, we just comb him, and now he's like, I'm so tired. Just do anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a great description, Kira.
Yeah.
We appreciate that. But that's all part of having a puppy, isn't it?
Yep.
And I know that you've all put a lot of thought and time into raising him to be a well-rounded puppy and a member of the family and the community. Did you also involve him in any training exercises over this last year? What all have you learned that way?
We did. We actually met with Denise in, I think it must have been April, about that time, and we went to puppy kindergarten. And that was a good experience for all of us. We really liked that.
Well, thank you so much for coming and telling your story.
Oh, you're
Amy,
welcome.
Kira, and Gabe. It's delightful. We're going to have to take a break. We'll be right back. Please stay with us. We have so much more to talk about. And we'll see you soon.
You're watching bctv.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For other stories and information, go to bctv.org.
Back and staying with us. Next on the agenda, we want to keep moving through, is Denise Lacey, our in-house resident trainer that we like to go to. She's our go-to girl for all kinds of things, and she's going to help us when things are going on in the household and it gets really, really crazy at the holidays, and our dogs are part of the family. We want them to be there, but there's a lot of stuff that comes up, so Denise is going to take us through that. Denise.
All right. Thanks, Barb. Pleasure to be back again. Just want to go over a couple of tips to maybe help make your holiday a little bit easier. We've got a little bit of PowerPoint to go on with this to give you some lists to go off of. When you're celebrating with your dogs, one of the really important things to keep in mind is that you want to do as much as you can to keep their routine the same as it always is. Dogs do really well with consistency, and the changes that happen at the holidays, people being home from work when they aren't normally home, maybe not getting the same walks and exercise can be tough on the dog. So as much as you can keep their routine the same, that helps them. Regular foods for our dogs are really important. We want to avoid doing lots of extra treats because it can upset their tummies. A little bit is good, but tons and tons of extra treats is tough. And that regular exercise and potty breaks are all going to be important. At the holidays, there are so many potential hazards that we want to keep an eye out for with our dogs. Toxic plants, poinsettias, mistletoe, holly, and lilies, all things that we like to decorate with, are just not good for our dogs. They have varying degrees of toxicity to them, so we want to watch out to keep those out of their way. Decorations, tinsel, edible ornaments, or garlands. If you put a string of popcorn around your Christmas tree, yeah, the dogs are going to find that. So you want to keep an eye out for that.
Not good.
Foods that are toxic for dogs, raisins, chocolates. We think about those year-round, but at the holidays, xylitol is something that's added to a lot of sugar-free foods that's highly toxic to our dogs. So we want to keep an eye out for that. And then when we're making those holiday dishes, things that are cooked with alcohol in them, we want to watch out for those with our dogs. I've heard countless stories of somebody making rolls for the holidays and the dogs stole the dough off the countertop. So you want to keep those things out of the way, fatty foods. Anything that involves heat or flame, candles, potpourri, Christmas lights, a dog following you around and then turning around and wagging a tail into a candle and knocking it over. Want to keep an eye out for that. And then with our trees, ornaments, packages, things that are breakable, if there's a package under your tree that contains something edible, you might not know it yet, but your dog is certainly going to be able to tell. So we want to make sure that we're keeping an eye out for that. So set up your dogs for success. Keep those fragile and hazardous items out of reach. Secure your tree. You can anchor it to the wall or protect it using an X-pen or some sort of a baby gate. Put it in a room that your dog can't get into, that you can close a door to. Or consider a table topper tree so you can get it up out of the dog's reach. And then again, a supervised or safe location. Then a big part of the holidays is having guests over, and we always want to have our dogs involved in that and be able to visit. So when guests arrive, that's not the time to start practicing our greeting skills. We want to make sure that we've practiced those ahead of time. If necessary, keep your dog in a secure place until all your guests have arrived, and then once that excitement of everybody coming in has died down, then go ahead and let them out to visit with everybody. Watch for signs of stress in your dog. Be willing to give them breaks in their visit. Lots of our dogs, while they may enjoy visiting with people, aren't used to doing it for hours on end. And so having them come out for 30 or 40 minutes and then have a chance to go take a break again is good. Supervised interactions are important. Our dogs may do great with kids one-on-one. They may have met all the children that are going to be over as guests. But there's a big difference between a one-on-one interaction with a child and your dog and four or five or eight kids swarming your dog. Even the best behaved dog may at some point in time decide enough is enough and I can't tolerate this anymore. So keep an eye on them with kids. If you want to have canine friends over, again, the dogs are part of our family. We want them to come with us at the holidays. If your dog has met the canine visitors before, that's great. But if these are new guests that they're not familiar with, the holidays and the increased level of stress that's going on already is not the best time to introduce new friends. So you probably want to hold off on new canine guests. And then chances to sneak snacks. You can ask your guests all you want not to give your dog food, but somebody's going to sneak them a treat, and then somebody else is going to sneak them a treat, and then somebody else. So sometimes it's a good idea if you can get your dog away when food is out with guests, just because everybody thinks, oh, I'll just give him one. But when you add it up to all of your guests, a lot of extra treats can be an upset tummy for your dog. Regardless of whether or not your dog gets along with visiting a lot of people or feels overstressed by the holidays, if they need to be away when guests are there, that's fine. But keep in mind that while every dog may not be comfortable with crowds, at the end when all your guests have gone home, they're still going to enjoy coming out and snuggling with you and enjoying that holiday time around the Christmas tree. I loved your story earlier about the
watching the Christmas movie with the dog and having popcorn. Yeah, that was great.
It's just so peaceful. And it's
nice, quiet time.
Yes.
Not stressful for the dog. One-on-one with their special person.
Yes.
A great way to spend the holiday.
Yeah,
with
it's fabulous. And as I said, too, I think it's that planned effort that you consciously pre-plan that and you make it happen.
And not every dog is going to be thrilled with the excitement of lots of guests, but they're always happy
to spend time
with their favorite people.
Yes, that's what they want. Yeah. Is that any more tips? I wanted to read another one that leads
No, that's it. That's got us for the holiday.
Well, thank you. They're fabulous. I hope some of you have jotted those down because there's so many of those great tips that Denise has. It's just excellent things you don't tend to think about, and you think, oh my goodness, I can easily control this. I shouldn't be so worried. I need to know what to do. So, anytime. She's available as well to ask her some tips for you, which again, that quiet time leads me to the story that I wanted to read you before that was submitted to us by one of our viewers. She called her story Silent Night, Holy Night. She said, peace on earth and goodwill toward men is in short supply if you are driving around the area this time of year. Christmas and the countdown to it are the most overscheduled, sleep-deprived time of the year for us. We frantically shop, cook, bake, wrap, and decorate ourselves into irritable grumps. We lie awake at night unable to stop obsessing on all that there is to do. But my two black retrievers, Mystic and Charlie, exude peace on earth and goodwill toward men. They adore a day spent in the kitchen, and they never tire of keeping the floor clean. When I'm stressing over all that there is to do, they snuggle up and distract me with a belly rub that needs attention. No one can be irritable when giving belly rubs. On Christmas Eve, I go to church. It's a beautiful service filled with joy, promise, and peace. We light candles and sing hymns, and there is something enchanting about Christmas Eve. It is transformative. I cannot wait to get home and revel in that most special night. Mystic and Charlie are canines, and they innately understand the magic of midnight on Christmas Eve. I grab their leashes, and off we go into the glory of the silent, holy night. And that's a fabulous tradition. Thank you so much, Leslie, for submitting that about Mystic and Charlie. Okay, moving on. We're running out of time. We want to show you some hot gifts in dogdom, and I know that they get four paws up on my dog's list. And the first one is hysterically funny. It's called a babble ball. So I'm going to pull this. Oh, maybe I better not pull it out. But I might hold that one for later. This is a kibble ball, which you can help give them a lot of exercise and energy by putting kibble in this. They roll it around, and they have to get the kibble out. There is a very durable flying disc, and it's called the Zisk. This will hold up. It doesn't rip. We use it in our play parks, and any dog will be thrilled. There's another product, a new product. It's hot off the product list. We've got it, and our dogs love it. It's called the Puller, and it's so durable and a lot of fun to throw it, fetch it, and play with it. And an antler. Don't forget a naturally shedded deer antler. The dogs love to chew these. They last. It's just vitamins and minerals and no meats. If you have an allergy dog, it's very durable. They can chew the marrow out. Look for something like this. And one of the favorites is this Hide a Squirrel, which I call it IntelliToys. It's interacting with your dog. They're very interactive. They pick them out and they put them in. And speaking of interactive toys, we have a nice demo over here with Denise's dog, Tilly. What she's doing, Denise, you tell us.
Tilly is playing with a dog brick. It's a puzzle for a dog to solve. This one has treats hidden in it under little sliding pieces that she has to move around to get to the cookies underneath. This particular one is a hand-me-down to her from three of my previous dogs, so it's held up very well through a Border Collie, a Lab, and another Schipperke. So this is a favorite toy. When the weather gets bad outside and you can't exercise your puppies physically, the mental stimulation of doing a puzzle is really good for burning off that energy. And actually, when weather gets really bad for Tilly, I'll have her do this puzzle 5 or 6 times to earn her dinner.
Oh,
and I'll just fill up the spaces, and when she empties it, we fill it again. So, great way for her to... Tilly says somebody's here.
Somebody's here. You're breaking up my puzzling.
Somebody's here.
Thank you, Denise. This is
in you go, Tilly.
This is the box of the dog brick, and it's just one of many puzzles. One of the leaders in developing these type of interactive toys is Nina Otteson. And like Brio Toys for Children years ago, the well-made wooden toys. These are holding up, as Denise said. Yes. This has really held up through different dogs really going at it and moving those bricks around, and it's fabulous to watch. We've done it with two dogs who get along very, very well, and there's no treat aggression, and it's really fun to watch them together. There are plastic toys like this. There are all kinds, and it's nice once you understand that your dog can do this and enjoys doing it with you to get a few varieties so that you can just have your own toy box pulling them out in the winter, as Denise said, when they get really, really bored. So thank you. That's been fun. There's a lot of hot products for gift giving and dogdom. There's things for grand dogs to give. We have a lot of ideas for that. But I see we have a surprise guest over here.
I think I know
here.
Why Tilly was barking.
Is she barking at Santa
she
Paws?
She knows. Santa Paws,
Santa Paws
is here.
Oh my goodness, let's bring Santa Paws over here. This is Santa Paws, a new tradition, or maybe for some of you an old tradition. Hello, Santa Paws. He is joining us tonight. Many puppies like to come to see him to give them their wishes. They've been naughty or nice. Hopefully puppies are thinking about naughty or nice right now. Santa Paws is here, and we would like to have a photo of ourselves with Santa. Denise, if you want to pose. He's going to wish us a very, very Merry Christmas, a happy holiday season, and I hope that your dogs and you enjoy one of the best holiday seasons together this year. I hope we've given you some wonderful ideas. And Santa Paws, is there anything else we should do with you today? Do you want to do the happy bone waving? And Tilly, yay, there he is. He's coming to us all the way from
the North Pole.
So Tilly saw him, and we again thank you so much. Please, in our closing slide, if you can give us some of your ideas about the show going forward and the things that you'd like to know about, also your stories. We love to feature folks whose lives have changed so much by having a dog in their life again, and just surprising them with the level of joy, the level of comfort, the level of what they bring to our lives. Please email us at dogisfamily@godfreysdogdom.com. Many of these products you can find in specialty stores. We also carry them at the store that I have. And we're willing to help anybody find what they need. And again, thanks so much. Enjoy and goodbye. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.